Our successes started actually before the season even began because we knew we had something special coming into the season. And with Dick's help and Coach Sisler, you know, they set up a different lineup that we had from our junior year going into our senior year because we knew we were going to be special. And then we took a spring trip that typically normal high school teams don't do. We went down to Central Illinois.
To the best of our knowledge, nobody had done that before. You played games during Easter break, but you always played them in Northern Illinois. And so many times the weather here was bad, so you didn't get in. You didn't get to play that many games during Easter break.
We had to get parents that would volunteer to be chaperones to go. We had to contact schools to see if they would be available to play. And as far as the housing went, the arrangement was is that when we went down there, you would stay with the player that played your position on the other team. And we put that together with the idea that we would come back, have a head start on everybody around here.
I think every one of us was a multi-sport athlete, and so we've had a lot of competition and friendships that had developed over our years in high school and being senior dominated. We were all very close, and to play with guys that you'd play with for 4 years, and some of these guys had gone back to Little League and played since then, so they've been playing together for a long time. To be on that team, to play with them, it was just an overwhelming experience that made you feel proud to be on that team. Win or lose, we were together and we stuck together.
We knew, Sam and I and a couple others knew, that we had the potential to have one heck of a season. Everybody had a very positive attitude when we went down. And it was really, we were all good friends, but getting together like that and traveling down there, it was what you hear about these days with a Blackhawks team or a Chicago Cubs team. That was the year that the team came together. With Coach Sisler and everything else, it just laid a great foundation.
We were so well trained and so well practiced. There were no home run fences in the outfield. So fly balls and line drives between the outfielders, the double relay was huge to try to hold a guy on third or keep him from scoring going to home. And we would practice, and Coach Sisler would be out there around the pitcher's mound with his fungo bat, smashing the ball between the outfielders and over their heads.
I mean, you couldn't take any, there was no dissension on our team. There was nobody that felt like they're superior. We all felt like we're doing a job and that we had something to prove, and we went about it in our own unique way and pulled for each other.
Playing on the team was great. But I think as a team, we were really focused on trying to do something that hadn't been done in a long time, and that is getting to a state tournament and hopefully winning it. So that was the focus that we had. And after we came back from the spring trip, I think we were two steps ahead of all the other teams in the conference. It was a tough conference. It was a very tough conference. Because in those days, in 1968, there were only eight schools in the conference. It was the Big Eight.
Coach Sisler prepared us for the game. You know, I'm sure Sam Zeller talked to him and talked to the pitchers about how we're going to pitch these guys in situations. But basically, we just went out and played the game. You know, if the coach wasn't telling us what to do on every pitch, he trusted that the team was ready to make the right decisions.
Coach Sisler was unique in a lot of different ways. He was a good baseball man. He understood the game, but he was willing to listen. A lot of our practices were set up by Dick Dummer and Coach. They'd talk about what we needed to do, where we think we needed to be, and we had a solid foundation of power, speed, good skills, and then good coaching. And that's where Coach Sisler came into play. And he was smart enough to put us in the positions where we could excel. Knew when somebody was struggling and when to pull them out. We had awesome pitching that year. We were four or five deep pitchers. And a couple of them were undefeated going into the state tournament. So we had good, solid baseball players all the way around the field.
The 1968 Guilford High School baseball team was the best. The players respected each other and enjoyed being together on a team. All the parts fit together perfectly. Their experience helped cement the guys into a fine working relationship.
A coach was always willing to listen. There's been coaches, I've seen coaches that, you know, there's only one way to do it, their way. Coach was willing to listen. He had some good ideas. He knew the game. It all focused on, would this be something that would benefit the team?
It was just good baseball, good fundamental baseball. You know, this is how the game is played. You know, we're going to work on these things, and then you guys are going to go out there and you're going to play the game the way we've practiced it.
The 1968 Guilford baseball team won first in the conference, first in the regional, first in the sectional, and got second in the state of Illinois. Wow, what a run. I'll never forget it.
I can almost go back to every single game and remember every pitch. And it's just one of those things that gets ingrained in the season as it is. Being inducted into the Hall of Fame, we were second in the state out of 488 teams. That's not bad.
Thank all those seniors for dragging me across the finish line as a member of the 1968 Guilford High School baseball team. And thank Coach Sisler, because he was also my coach when I was a senior, and playing for him was such a pleasure, because this is the way we're going to play the game. You and your catcher figure it out. Go out there and let's win.
And again, I'm just thankful. I think I speak for Sam and everybody else. We are thankful that we are given the opportunity. It means a lot.